So with that, I'll finally say that this land acknowledgement from my ancestors, my Taino ancestors, through these words to all of you, I hope that you can help me feel. OSA is situated on Huchin. Can everyone say the word Huchin? Thank you. The unceded territories of the Chochenyo-speaking Lishon Ohlone peoples who have lived upon this land since the beginning of time. Indigenous peoples in California, the Americas, and around the world are still here. OSA recognizes the forced removal from ancestral lands and the deliberate and systematic destruction of their communities and culture that are still going on, which is why indigenous people are still defending against cultural erasure and fighting for their sovereignty. To this end, we strive to honor the indigenous members of our community, uplift their voices and contributions to arts and culture, center those worldviews in our classrooms, and support sovereignty everywhere. This land acknowledgement is a small act in supporting justice, equity, diversity, inclusion, and solidarity with indigenous nations. Rematriate by donating time and money to indigenous-led organizations, amplify their voices and movements, and return the land. And with that, I'll say these last words of blessing. If music be the food of love,
Laya!
I'm Sophia Valdez, and I play Violet Python.
I'm Parker Skelton, and I play Captain Valentine.
I'm Noah Villarreal, and I play Orsino.
I'm Jen Russ, and I play Sir Toby Belch.
I am Akaya Hiley, and I play Mariah.
I am Luke Heidishman, and I play Sir Andrew Aguchi.
I am Josephine Thompson, and I play Olivia.
I am Messiah Burks, and I play Bestie.
I'm Frank Lose Younger, and I play Mongolio.
I'm Alicia Turner, and I play Fabian.
I am Orion, and I play Priest Topax.
I'm Rosaria Jackson Ships, and I play Sebastian.
I'm Gemma Griffin, and I play Antonio.
I'm Luna Scott Chung, and I'm Assistant Director.
Hello, my name is Simon Bueller Reardon, and I am one of the assistant directors and working stage managing this fall.
Thank you.
The last days of Oakland.
The Black Panthers.
The end of something. Beginning of something. The last days of Oakland.
Right,
there's good in the old Oakland.
Free speech.
There's good in the new Oakland.
Nice places.
Let's make a sandwich.
It's so expensive.
Let's make a new baby.
Just to survive?
Yeah. The seeds were planted long ago. Let's watch the tree grow.
What country, friends, is this?
This is Oakland, lady. North!
Oakland!
South!
South! Oakland!
East!
Oakland!
West!
Oakland!
And what should I do in Oakland? My brother, he is in heaven. Perchance he is not drowned. What think you, Tinkler?
It is perchance that you yourself were saved.
Oh, my poor brother. And so perchance may he be.
True, madam. But to comfort you with chance, assure yourself. After our ship did split when you and those poor numbers safe with you hung upon our driving boat, I saw your brother, most prevident in peril, bind himself, courage and hope of teaching him the practice, to a strong mast that live upon the sea. We're like Aquaman on the dolphin's back. I saw him hold acquaintance with the waves so long as I could see.
For saying so, there's love. Mine own escape unfoldeth to my hope, whereto thy speech serves for authority, the like of him. Knowest thou this country?
Aye, madam, well, for I was bred and born not 3 hours' travel from this very place.
Who governs here?
A noble duke, in nature as in name.
What is the name?
Orsino.
Orsino? I have heard how my father named him. He was a bachelor then.
Yeah, and so is now, or was so very late. For but a month ago I went from hence that he did seek the love of fair Olivia.
What's she?
A virtuous maid, the daughter of a count who died some 12 months since, then leaving her in the protection of his son, her brother, who shortly also died. For whose dear love, they say, she hath abjured the company in sight of men.
Oh, that I served that lady, and might not be delivered to the world till I had made mine own occasion mellow what my estate is.
That were hard to compass, as you will admit no kind of suit. No, not the Duke's.
There is a fair behavior in thee, Captain, and though that nature with a beauteous wall doth oft close in pollution, I will believe thou hast a mind that suits with this thy fair and outward character. I prithee, and I'll pay thee bounteously. Conceal me what I am, and be my aid, for such disguise shall haply become the form of my intent. I'll serve this Duke. Thou shalt present me as a man to him. It may be worth thy pains, for I can speak and sing to him in many sorts of music that will allow me very worth his service. What else may hap, to time I will commit, only shape thou silence to my wit.
Hmm. Well, be you his man, and your mute I'll be. For when my tongue blabs, let mine eyes not see.
I thank you. Lead me on.
Not so sweet now as it was before.
O spirit of love, how quick and fresh thou art, that notwithstanding thy capacity, receiveth as the sea, not enters there, of what validity and pitch soe'er, but falls into abatement and low price.
Will you go hunt, my lord?
What, Valentine?
The heart.
Why, so I do, the noblest that I have. Oh, when mine eyes did see Olivia first, methought she purged the air of pestilence. That moment was I turned to a heart, and my desires, like fell and cruel hounds, e'er since pursued me. What news from her?
So please, my lord, I might not have been admitted, but from her handmaid I do return this answer. The element itself, till 7 years' heat, shall not behold her face at ample view. And like a cloistress, she will veiled walk and water once a day her day around with eye-offending brine. All this to season a brother's dead love, which she would keep fresh and lasting in her sad remembrance.
Oh, that she had a heart of this fine frame to pay this debt of love but to a brother. How will she love when the rich golden shaft hath killed the flock of all affections else that live in her, when liver, brain, and heart, these sovereign thrones, are all supplied, supplanted with one self-same king? Away before me to great beds of flowers, love thoughts lie rich when canopied with bowers.
Oh, what a plague means my niece to take the death of her brother thus. I am sure care is an enemy to life.
By my truth, sir, you must have been earlier all night. Your cousin, my lady, has taken great exceptions to your ill hour.
Well, let her accept before accepted.
Aye, but you must confine yourself within the modest limits of order.
Confine? I'll confine myself no finer than I am. These clothes are good enough for drinking, and so be these boots, too.
That drinking will undo you. I heard my lady talk of it yesterday, and of a foolish knight you brought in one night to be her wooer.
Who, Sir Andrew Eguchi?
Aye, he.
Why, he's as tall as any man in Oakland.
What is that to the purpose?
Well, he has 3,000 bitcoins per year.
Aye, have all but a year in all these bitcoins. He's a very fool and a prodigal.
Prithee, you'll say so. He plays the violin, speaks three or four languages word for word without book, and he hath all the good gifts of nature.
He hath indeed almost natural, for besides that he's a fool, a great quarreler, and but that he hath the gift of a coward to allay the gust he hath in quarreling. 'Tis among the prudent he quickly hath the gift of a grape.
By this hand they are scoundrels and subtractors, they suck to them. Who are they?
That they add, moreover, he shrunk nightly in your company.
With drinking health to my niece, I'll drink to her as long as there's a passage in my throat, and drink in Oakland! He's a coward hunter who would not drink to my niece. Ah, here comes Sir Andrew Agua! What's his name? Agu-face! Sir Toby, bow chow now, Sir Toby, bow! Sweet Sir Andrew!
Bless you, fair shrew.
And you too, sir.
A cost, Sir Andrew, a cost.
What's that?
My niece's chambermaid.
Good mistress, a cost. I desire better acquaintance.
My name is Mary, sir.
Good mistress, Mary, a cost.
You mean the ignite, a cost is front her, board her, boo her, a sister.
By my truth, I would not undertake her in this company. Is that the meaning of a cost?
Fare you well, gentlemen.
And let that part so. It's not going to draw a sword again, Sir Andrew.
And you part so, mistress. I might never draw a sword again. Fair lady, do you think you have fools in hand?
Sir, I have not you by the hand.
Mary, but you shall have. And here is my hand.
Now, sir, thoughts is free. I pray you bring your hand to the buttery bar and let it drink.
Why, I think so. I'm not... Wherefore, sweetheart, what's your metaphor?
Try, sir.
Well, I think so, but I can't keep my hand dry. But what's your jest?
A dry jest, sir.
Are you full of them?
Aye, sir, I have them at my fingers' ends. Mary, now I let them go, I am barren.
Oh, knight, thou lackest a cup of kombucha! When did I see thee sober down?
Never in your life, I think, unless you see. Kombucha! Put me down. Methinks I have no more wit than a Christian or an ordinary man has, but I am a great eater, and I believe that does harm to my wit.
What a question.
I thought that all forswear. I'll ride home tomorrow, Sir Toby.
Porque, my dear knight?
What is porque? Do or not do? Oh, I wish I had bestowed the time and the tongues that I have in rapping, twerking, and side-showing. Oh, had I but followed the arts.
Then thou shalt have an excellent head of hair.
What would that have mended my hair?
Past question, thou seest it will not curl by nature.
That it becomes me well enough, does it not?
Well, excellent, excellent. It hangs like flax on a distaff. And I hope to see a housewife take thee between her legs and spin it.
Oh. They go home tomorrow, Sir Toby. Your niece will not be seen, or if she be, she'll none of me the duke here, hardly woos her.
She will none of the duke. I've heard her swear it, toot this life and man.
I'll stay a month longer.
Yes!
I am a fellow as strange as mine in the world. I delight in masks and revels sometimes. Altogether.
Art thou good at these knights?
Wait, I can cut a caper.
And I can cut the mutton toot.
And I have the back track simply as strong as any man in Oakland.
Wherefore are these things said? Well, it's not a good attrition of Macarena, a good woman of Bugaloo. I did think by the excellent constitution of thy leg, it was formed under the star of a dancer.
Aye, that is well enough in a plain colored stock, but shall we set about some revel?
What shall we do else? We're not born in a Taurus? Oh.
Taurus, that size and heart.
No, sir, it is legs and thighs. Let me see the caper.
Ha ha ha! Excellent!
The Duke continues these favors towards you, Cesario. You are much advanced, yeah. Shoulders up, you gotta look like a man. Hold on, I've got Axe body spray for you. Yes, pungent, right? He hath known you but 3 days, and already you are no stranger.
You are your fear, his humor, or my negligence that you call into question the continuance of his love. Is he is inconstant, sir, in his favors?
No, believe me.
I thank you. Here comes the Duke.
Hey, yo, hit it! She will attend it better in thy youth than in a viejo of more grave aspect.
I think not so, my lord.
Dear lad, believe it. The goddess is not more smooth and rubious. Thy small pipe is as the maiden's organ, shrill and sound, and all is semblative of a woman's part. I know thy constellation is a shaft for this affair. Four or five attend him. All if you will. You will. For I myself am blessed when least in company. Prosper well in this, and thou shalt live as freely as thy lord to call his fortunes thine.
I'll do my best to woo your lady. Yet a bearful strife, for whoever I woo, myself would be his wife. Nay, I prithee, either tell me where thou hast been, or I shall open my lips so wide as a bristle may enter in way of thy excuse. My lady will hang thee for thy absence.
Let her hang me. He that is well hanged in this world needs to fear no colors.
Make that good.
Oh, he shall see none to fear.
Good answer. I could tell thee where that saying was born of. Fear no colors.
Where, good Mistress Mary?
In the wars, and that you may be so bold to say in your foolery.
Well, God give the ones them that have it, and those who are fools, let them use their talent.
Yet you will be hanged for being so long absent, or to be turned away. Is that not as good as a hanging to you?
Why, many a good hanging prevents a bad marriage. And for turning away, let summer bear it out.
Oh, you're loose then.
Neither, but I am resolved on 2 points.
That if one break, the other will hold. But if both break, your skirt, your small.
Apt in good faith, very apt. If go thy way, if Sir Tony would leave drinking, thou wert as witty as a piece of used flesh as in any open.
Pace, you rogue, none of that. Here comes my lady. Make your excuse wisely. You are best.
Sir Toby, madam, your kinsman.
Fetch him off, I pray you. He speaks nothing but madmen. Fie on him. Go you too, Malvolio, for if it is a suit from the Duke, I am not at home or sick. What you will to dismiss it. Go, 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 go. Now you see, fool, how your fooling grows old and people grow tired of it.
Well, thou hast spoke for us, Madonna, as if thy eldest son should be a fool. Whose skull got crammed with brains? Oh, wait, for here he comes.
By mine honor, half drunk? What is this?
Ouch! Oh, I'm sorry. A gentleman is there.
A gentleman? What gentleman?
Tis a gentleman there at the gate. A plague all these big alarming. How now, something is there. How you doing?
Oh, why good Sir Toby.
Cousin, why hast thou come so early by this lethargy?
Lechery, huh? My lechery, there's one at the gate.
Hi, Mary, what is he?
Oh, why? A drunken man. One drink above, he makes him a fool. Second man, and a third round him.
Oh, let him be the dimby, and he will. I cannot. Give me faith, say I. Well, it's all one.
Take him to the coroner, for he's in the third degree of drink. He's drowned.
Oh, he's not mad yet, Madonna, and the fool shall look to the madman. Toodles.
Madam, yon young fellow swears here to speak with you. I with you, him you were sick. He seems to understand so much and therefore comes to speak with you. I told him you were asleep. He seems to have a foreknowledge of that too and therefore comes to speak with you. What is to be said to him, lady? He's fortified against any denial. Tell him he shall not speak with me.
Has been told so, and he says he'll stand at your gate like a sheriff's post and be this a bench, but he will speak with you.
What kind of man is he?
Why, of mankind?
What manner of man?
Oh, a very ill manner. He'll speak with you, will you or no?
Let him approach. Let him approach. Call in my gentlewoman.
Okay, gentlewoman, my lady calls.
Good, Mariah, come. Give me my veil. We'll once more hear Arsina's embassy. The honorable lady of the house, which is she? Speak to me. I shall answer for her. Your will? Most radiant, exquisite, and unmatchable beauty. I pray you, tell me if this be the lady of the house, for I never saw her. I would be loath to cast away my speech, for besides that it is excellently well penned, I have taken great pains to con it. Good beauty, good. Let me sustain no scorn. I am very comfortable, even to the least sinister usage. Whence came you, sir? I can say little more than I have studied, and that question's out of my part. Good gentlewoman, give me modest assurance, if you be the lady of the house, that I may proceed in my speech.
Are you a comedian?
No. My profound heart, yet by the very things of malice, I swear I am not what I play. Are you the lady of the house?
If I do not usurp myself,
I am. Most certain, if you are she, you do usurp yourself, for what is yours to bestow is not yours to reserve. But this is from my commission. I will on with my speech in your praise, and then show you the heart of my message.
Come to what is important in it. I forgive you the praise.
But alas, I took great pains to study it, and 'tis poetical.
'Tis more like to be fayed. I pray you keep it in. I heard you were saucy at my gates, and allowed your approach to wonder at you rather than to hear you. If you be mad, be gone. If you've reason, be brief. 'Tis not the time of moon with me to be in one so skipping a dialogue.
Will you hoist sail, sir? Here lies your way.
No, good swabber. I am to hold here a little longer.
Some mollification for your giant, sweet lady. Tell me your mind. I am a messenger.
Sure, you have some hideous matter to deliver when the courtesy of it was so fearful. Speak your office.
It alone concerns your ear. I bring no overture of war, no taxation of homage. I hold the olive in my hand. My words are as words of pieces.
Yet you began rudely.
Are you? What would you?
The rudeness that hath appeared in me, I have learned from my entertainment.
What I am and what I would are as secret as maidenhead. To your ears, divinity. To any others, profanation.
Give us place alone. We shall hear this.
Divinity.
sweet lady. Comfortable doctrine, and much may be said of it. Where lies your text? In Orsino's bosom! In his bosom! In what chapter of his bosom? To answer by the method in the first of his heart. Oh, I have heard it. It is heresy. Have you no more to say? Good madam, let me see your face. Have you any commission from your lord to negotiate with my face? You are now out of your text. But we will draw the curtain and show you the picture. Look you, sir. Such a one I was this present, tis it not well done?
Excellently done, if God did all.
Tis ingrained, sir. T'will endure wind and weather.
Tis beauty truly blent, whose red and white features all sweet and cunning hand laid on. Lady, you are the cruelest she alive if you will leave these graces to the grave and leave the world no copy.
Oh, I will not be so hard-hearted. I shall send out divers schedules of my beauty so that every particle and utensil is labeled to my will, such as item, two lips in different red, item, two gray eyes with lids to them, item, one chin, one neck, and so on. Were you sent hither to praise me?
I see you what you are. You are too proud. But if you were the devil, you are fair.
My lord and master loves you. Oh, such love could be but recompensed, though you were crowned the nonpareil of beauty.
How does he love me?
With adorations, with fertile tears, with groans that thunder love, with sighs of fire.
Your lord does know my mind, yet I cannot love him. Though I know him noble, suppose him virtuous, of Great voices well divulged, fresh, free, learned, and valiant, a gracious man. But yet, I cannot love him.
He may have took his answer long ago.
If I loved you in my master's flame, with such a suffering, such a deadly life, in your denial, I would find no sense.
Why? What would you? Why? Which would you?
Make me a willow cabin at your gate, and call upon my soul within the house. Write loyal cantons of condemned love, and sing them loud even in the dead of night. Hallow your name to the reverberate hills, and make the babbling gossip of the air cry out, Olivia! Oh, you should not rest between the elements of air and earth. But you should pity me.
You might do much. What is your parentage?
Above my fourth, my state as well. I am a gentleman.
Get you to your lord. Get you to your lord. Tell him to send no more. Unless perchance you were to come again to me, to tell me how he takes it. Fare thee well. I thank you for your pains. Spend this for me.
Keep your purse, lady. I'm no feed post. My master, not myself, lacks all one pence. Love make his heart a flint that you shall love, and let your fervor, like my master's, be placed in contentment. Farewell, fair cruelty.
What is your parentage? Above my fortune, yet my state as well. I am a gentleman. I'll be sworn thou art thy type, face, limbs, essence, and spirit do give thee fivefold place.
Not too fast. Not too fast. Soft. Soft. Unless the master were the man.
How now, even so quickly, may one catch the plague?
Well, let it be.
What ho, Malvolio?
Here, madam, at your service.
Run after that same peevis messenger, the county's man, for he left this ring behind him. Will I or not, tell him I'll none of it. Desire him not to flatter his lord or hold his hopes high. I am not for him. If he's to come again in this way tomorrow, I'll give him reason for it. Go, hide thee, Malvolio. I know in what I fear to find. show thy force. For ourselves we do not owe what is decreed must be, and be this so.
But I perceive in you so excellent a touch of modesty that you will not extort from me what I am willing to keep in. Therefore, it charges me in manners the willing to express myself. You must know me then, Antonio. My name is Sebastian, from which I call Rodrigo. My father was that Sebastian of Mexico, from whom you have heard of. You left behind him, myself, and a sister, both born in an hour. If the heavens would have been pleased with me, I would be so ended. But you, sir, altered that. For some hour before you took me to the breach of the sea, where my sister drowned.
What's the day?
A lady, sirs. But what was said was such resembled me was yet of the many accounted beautiful. But with such estimable number over for I believe that I will boldly publish her. She bore a mind that envy that not but call fair. She is drowned already, sir. With salt water. Though I seem to drown her remembrance again more.
Sebastian, pardon your dad and our famous.
Oh, good Antonio, forgive me your trouble.
If you will not murder me for my love, let me be your servant.
If you will not undo what you have done, that is, kill him who you have recovered, desire it not. Fare you well. My bosom is some is highness. And yet I am so near the manners of my mother that upon the least occasion more my eyes will tell tales of me. I am bound to the Duke Orsino's court. Farewell.
The gentleness of all the gods go with thee.
No, I have many enemies in Orsino's court.
Else would I shortly see thee there.
No, I could die, but I do not want them alive.
Oh, no one? But come with May. I do adore thee so. You know what? I'm gonna do it. The danger shall seem sport, and I will go.
Poor lady, she were better love a dream. The
wickedness wherein the pregnant enemy does much. How easy is it for the proper false and women's waxen hearts to set their forms? Alas, our frailty is the cause, not we. For such as we are made of, such we be. How will this badge? My master loves her dearly. And I, poor monster, just as fond on him. And she, mistaken, seems to dote on me. What will become of this? As I am man, my state is desperate for my master's love. As I am woman, alas the day. What thrift sighs shall poor Olivia breathe? Oh, time, thou must untangle this, not I. It is too hard a knot for me to untie.
Approach, Sir Andrew, not to be a bed after midnight is to bed is out betimes. Thou knowest.
Nay, my truth, I know not, but I know to be a plate is to be a blade.
A false conclusion. To go to bed after midnight and to be up after midnight and to go to bed that is early. So to go to bed after midnight is to go to bed betimes. Sir, last night was just the Parliament's.
Faith, so they say, but I think it rather consists of eating and drinking.
Thou art the scholars, let us therefore eat and drink. Mariah, a stoop of kombucha.
Here comes the bull, I think.
Well, how now, my hearts? Did you never see the photo of we three?
Welcome, Ashlyn, to catch you song.
By my truth, the fool has an excellent breast. I had rather than 40 bitcoins, I had such a leg, and so sweet a voice to sing as the fool has. In sooth, thou wast in very gracious fooling last night. Twas good, I faith. I sent thee $6 for thy lover, hats.
I do, or Marvolio's nose is no whipstock. My lady has a white hand, and the Kardashians are no Butterwell houses.
Excellent, why, this is the best fooling when all is done. No, a song.
Come, there is, let's see, there is $6 in it for you. Let's have a song.
Would you have a love song or a song of good life?
A love song.
I care not for good life.
Oh, so you please.
Indeed. Shall we rouse the night owl and a cat shall draw three souls from one weaver? Shall we do that?
If you love me, let's do it. I am dog and a cat.
Oh, yes, sir, and some dogs will catch well.
Most certain, let our catch be thou, Karen.
Wait. Hold thy peace, thou Karenite. I shall be constrained in it to call thee Karenite.
It's not the first time I've constrained one to call me Karen. Begin, poet begins. Hold thy peace.
Well, I shall never begin if I hold my peace.
Hi, excuse me. Hello, up there. Good enough.
The devil a Republican.
Republican, that he is, or anything constantly but a fool. A common recreation that utters it by great source, utters it by book. So crammed as he thinks with excellencies, that it is his grounds of faith that all that look upon him love him. And on that device will leave my revenge no little cause to work.
What wilt thou do?
I will drop in his way some obscure episode of love, the color of his beard, the shape of his leg, the manner of his gait, the expression in his eyes, nose, and forehead. He shall find himself most feelingly personated. I can write very much like my lady. On a forgotten manner, we can hardly make distinction of our hands.
Oh, excellent, excellent. I smell... Oh, I smell a device!
I have it in my nose, too. Oh, wait, no. That's my lunch.
He shall think but a little that will drop that emerges. That she is in love with him.
Thank you. My purpose is indeed a horse of that color.
And your horse... would make him an ass?
Ass, I doubt not.
Oh, duly admirable!
Sport Royal, I warrant you, I know my physical work with him. I'll plant you two. Let that fool make a third. He shall find a letter, observe his construction of it, from this night to bed, and dream on the event. Farewell.
Good night, Wonder Woman!
Before me, she's a good one.
That she is. She's a beagle, true bred, and one that adores me. What of that?
I was adored once too.
Come night. That's the bed. That has need to send for more money.
I cannot recover. In the foul way out.
Go, sir. Send for her money. But has her not in the end come and cut?
And I do not. I get how you go.
Come night. I can burn some sack. Come night. It's too late to come in now. Give me some music. Now, good Mono Frag. Now, good Cesario, with that old and antique song we heard last night, we thought it did relieve me the passions much more than light airs and recollected terms of these risk and giddy pace times. Come but one verse.
He is not here, so yes. Please, your lordship, that should sing it.
Who was it then?
Bestie, the jester, my lord, and fooled the Lady Olivia's father took much delight in. He's about the house.
Seek him out and play the tune the while. Cesario, come. If ever thou shalt love, in the sweet pangs of it remember me. For such as I am, all true lovers are, unstained and skittish in all motions else. For the constant image of the creature that is beloved. How dost thou like this tune?
It gives a very difficult to the seat where love is from.
My life upon it, thou dost sing masterfully. Young that thou art, thine eye hath strayed upon some creature that it favors. Hath it not, boy?
A little by your favor.
What kind of woman is?
Of your complexion?
She is not worthy, then. What year is it, Faith?
About your years, my lord.
Too old, by heaven. But still the woman taken elder than herself, so wears she to him some sways she level in her husband's heart. For, boy, however we do praise ourselves, our desires are far more giddy and unfirm, sooner lost and worn than women's are.
I think it well, my lord.
Dear lad, believe it, and let thy love longer than thyself, else thy affection can hold the bent. For women are as roses, whose fair flower, being once doth fall that very hour.
So they are. Alas that they are so. To die even when they to perfection grow.
Good fellow! The song we had last night, Market Cesario, it is old and plain. The knitters and the spinsters and the free maids that weave their cloth with bones did used to chant it. It is silly, Smith, and dallies with the innocence of love like the old age.
Are you ready? See, ready?
I prithee sing.
Ooh, music, please.
Same sovereign cruelty. Tell her my love, more noble than the world, prizes not quantities of dirty lands, but the parts that fortune hath bestowed upon her. Tell her I hold as giddily as fortune, but 'tis that miracle and queen of gems that nature pranks within her attracts my soul.
But if she cannot love you, sir.
I cannot be so answered.
Sooth, but you must say that some lady, as perhaps there is, hath for your love a greater pang of heart as you have for Olivia. You cannot love her, you tell her so. Must she not then be so answered?
There is no woman's heart can bide the beating of so strong a passion as love doth give mine. Their hearts are not so big, they lack retention. Truly, their love may be called appetite. No motion of the liver, but the palate that suffers surfeit, cloyment, and revolt. But mine is all as hungry as the sea and can digest as much. Therefore, make you no compare between that love a woman can bear me and that I owe Olivia.
But I know.
What dost thou know?
Too well what love women to men may owe. And they are as true of heart as we. My father had a daughter, loved a man as man might be, perhaps were a woman, your lordship.
And what's her history?
A blank, my lord. She never told her love, but let concealment like a worm in the bud beat on her damask cheek. She pined in thought, with a green and yellow melancholy, fat like patience on a monument, smiling at grief. Was this not love indeed? We men may say more, swear more, but in faith, our shows are more than will, for still, we prove much in our vows, but little in our love.
But died thy sister of her love, my boy?
I am all the daughters of my father's house, and all brothers too, yet I know not. Sir, shall I to this lady?
Aye, that's the theme. To her in haste, give her this ring and say, my love can bid no place, bid no denay.
Come thy ways, fabulous Fabian!
Now y'all come and close a scruple up this sport. Let me be boiled to death with melancholy.
I'll want to see the rascally sheep fighter come by some notable shame.
I would exalt, man. You know he brought me out of favor with my lady about a side chunk here.
To anger him, we'll have the bear again. And we'll fool him black and blue, showing Sir Andrew.
You're not, it is pity of our lives.
Oh, the villain. How now, my metal of America?
Oh, how I work with such slackers. Get off this intense. Yon Volio's coming down this walk. He's been yonder in the sun, practicing his own behavior this half hour. Observe him for the love of mockery, for I know this letter will make a contemplative idiot of him. Close, the name is Justin. Wait here, and that means pause. Open. For here comes the trout that must be caught with the tickling.
How's it going? You like the show? I did too. So anyway, tis fortune. Oh, is fortune. Mariah once told me she did affect me, and I have heard her come thus near that should she fancy it should be one of my complexion. Besides, she uses me with a more exalted respect than anyone else that follows her. What should I think on it?
Here's never winning rogue.
Oh, peace. Contemplation makes a rare turkey cocky of how you jest under his advanced plumes.
So beat the rogue. Peace, peace.
To be Count Malvolio.
Oh, rogue.
Pistol him. Peace, I say. Get back here.
Telling my officers about me in my branched velvet gown, having come from a daybed where I've left Olivia sleeping.
All for a stone bow to hit them in the eye!
And then to have the humor of state. And after a demure travel of a guard, telling them I know my place as I would they should do theirs, to for my kinsman Toby.
Fire and brimstone!
Peace, peace!
7 of my people with an obedient star. Make out for him, I frown the while, and perchance wind up watch or play with mine.
Rich jewel.
Toby approaches, curtsies there to me.
Shall this fellow live?
Though our silence be drawn from us with cards, yet peace!
I extend my hand to him thus, quenching my familiar smile with an austere guard of control.
What?
Saying, Cousin Toby, my fortunes having cast me upon your niece, give me this prerogative of speech. You must amend your drunkenness.
Out, scab!
Patience, or we break the sinews of our plot!
Besides, you waste the treasure of your time with a foolish knight.
That's me, I warrant you.
And Sir Andrew.
I knew 'twas I for many do call me fool.
What employment have we here?
Now is Wilcock near the gin.
Peace, in the spirit of good humor, the intimate reading allowed to him.
By my life, this is my lady's hand. These be her very C's, her U's, and her T's, and thus makes she her great P's. It isn't contempt to question her hand.
Her C's, her U's, and her T's, why that?
The
unknown beloved this and my good wishes. Her very phrases. By your leave, wax soft, and the impression she uses to seal. Tis my lady, to whom should this
This wins them, liver and all.
Jove knows I love.
But who?
Lips do not move, no man must know. No man must know. What follows? The numbers altered. No man must know. If this should be thee, Malvolio.
Oh.
I may command where I adore. Why, she may command me. I serve her. She is my lady. This is evident to any formal capacity. There is no obstruction in this. And in the end, what should this alphabetical position portend? Softly, I can make this resemble something in me. M-O-A-I.
Oh, he's had a cold scent.
Don't be as rank as a fox.
M. Malvolio? M. Why, that begins my name?
Did I not say he would work it out? The cur is excellent. I fall.
M. But then there is no consonancy in the sequel that suffers under the probation that A should follow, but O does.
And O shall end, I hope.
Aye, you're all cut to make him cry, O!
And then I comes behind?
Hey, if you had any eye behind you, you might see more detraction at your heels than fortunes before you.
M-O-A-I. This simulation is not as the former, and yet to crush this allure without to me. Every one of these letters is in mine. Soft, here follows prose. This fall into thy hand, revolve. In my stars I am above thee, but be not afraid of greatness. Some are born great, some achieve greatness, and some have greatness thrust upon it. Ooh, rust. Thy fates open their hands, let thy blood and spirit embrace them, and to inure thyself to what thou art like to be, cast thy humble self and appear fresh. Be opposite with a kinsman, surly with servants, let thy tongue tang argument art state. Put thyself into the trick of singularity she thus advises thee that sighs for thee. Remember who commended thy yellow stockings and wish to see thee ever cross-gartered, I say remember. Go to, thou art made if thou desirest to be so. If not, let me see thee a steward still, the fellow of servants, and not worthy to touch fortune's fingers. Farewell. She that would alter services with thee, the fortunate unhappy. Daylight and champagne discovers not more. This is open. I will be proud. I will read poetic authors. I will baffle Sir Toby. I will wash off gross acquaintance. I will point of eyes the very man. I do not now fool myself to let imagination jade me, for every one, every reason excites to this. That my lady loves me. She did commend my yellow stockings, did praise my leg being cross-guarded, and in this she manifests herself to my love with a kind of injunction that drives me to these habits of her liking. I thank the stars I am happy. I will be strange, stout, in cross, in yellow stockings, and cross-guarded, even with the swiftness of putting on. Jove and my stars be praised. Here's yet a postscript. Thou canst not choose but know who I am. If thou entertainest my love, let it appear in thy smiling. Thy smiles become thee well. Therefore, in my presence, still smile, dear my sweet, I prithee. Joe, you can hear me. I will smile. I will do everything that thou wilt tempt me.
Another jest.
Nor I neither.
Here comes my noble ball catcher.
Or won't thou set thy foot on my neck?
Or on mine either.
Shall I play with thy freedom and become thy bond slave?
I faith, or I either.
Nay, but say true, does it work upon him?
Like Uncle Vita and a midwife.
If you will see the fruit of the sport, mark his first approach before my lady. He will appear to her in yellow stockings as a country horse and cross-garnered, a fashion she absolutely detests. And he will smile upon her, which will now be so insinuable to her contempt that I cannot but turn him into an contempt. If you will see it, follow me. Run a walk.
To the gates of our most excellent devil of wit.
Since words are grown so false, I am loath to prove reason with them.
I warrant thou art a merry fellow and cares for nothing.
Oh, sir, I do care for something, but in my conscience I do not care for you. If that be not to care for nothing, I would make you invisible.
Art not thou the Lady Olivia's fool?
Oh, nay, sir, the Lady Olivia has no folly. She'll keep no fool till she be married, as husbands are anchovies, as anchovies are to sardines. The husband's the bigger. I'm not her fool, but her corrupt efforts.
I saw thee late at the Duke Orsino's.
Aye, sir. Foolery does walk the orb like the sun. It shines everywhere. I think I saw your wisdom there.
Nay, I'll not make a pass upon me all the more with thee.
Oh.
Here's expenses for thee.
Ooh, now Jove and his next commodity send thee a beard.
Oh, by my truth, I tell thee, I'm almost sick for one. Though I would not have it grow on my chin. Is thy lady within?
What a pair of these have bred, sir?
Yes, being kept together and put to use.
Hmm.
I would play Drex to bring a Kylie to this traffic.
I understand you, sir. Tis well begged.
The matter is begging but a beggar. Kylie was a beggar. But indeed, I will vent to my lady once you come. You are what you are, out of my winking. I would say elements, but the word is overborne.
This fellow is wise enough to play the fool. To do that well craves a kind of wit. He must observe their mood on whom he jests, the quality of persons, and the time, and like a haggard, check at every feather that comes before his eye. It is a practice as full of labor as the wise man's art, for folly that he wisely shows is fit, but wise men, folly fallen, quite take their wit.
Save you, gentlemen.
And you, sir.
Dios lo salve, señor.
Y usted también, su seguro servidor.
I hope, sir. You are and I am yours.
My niece is most desirous you should enter tonight, if your trade be to her.
I am bound to your niece, sir. I mean, she's the lift of my voyage.
Well then go, sir. Taste your legs. Put them to motion.
My legs do better understand me, sir, than I understand what you mean by bidding me taste my legs.
I mean to enter.
I will answer you with gate and entrance. But we are prevented. Most excellent, accomplished lady, the heavens rain odors upon you.
This you, silver air courtier, rain odors, wow.
My matter hath no voice but to your most pregnant and vouchsafed ear.
Odor, pregnant, vouchsafe, I'll get them all three already.
Let the garden door be shut and leave me to my hearing. Give me your hand, sir. What is your name? Cesario is your servant's name, fair princess.
My servant, sir. 'Twas never a merry world since Lily Failing was called to compliment. Your servant, the Duke Orsino, youth.
And he is yours, and his must needs be yours. Your servant's servant is your servant, madam.
For him, I think not of him, for his thoughts would they were blanks rather than filled with me.
Madam, I come to wet your gentle thoughts on his behalf.
By your leave, I pray you. I bade you never speak again of him.
But if you were to undertake another suit, I had rather hear you to solicit that than music from the spheres.
Dear lady,
give me leave, beseech you. I did send, after the last enchantment you did here, a ring in chase of you. So did I abuse myself, my servant, and I fear me, you. Under your hard construction must I sit, to force that on you in shameful cunning to which you knew none of yours. What might you think of me? Have you not already set mine honor at the stake and baited it with the most unmuzzled thoughts that a tyrannous heart can think of? What if you have to have a soul? A cypress, not a bosom. If my heart, let me hear you speak.
Pity you.
That's a degree to love.
No, not at all. For 'tis vulgar proof that very oft we pity enemies.
Well, then methinks 'tis time to smile again. Oh, world, how apt the poor are to be pressed. If one is to fall prey, how better to fall before the lion than the wolf?
Fear not, good youth, for I will not have you. And yet when good wit and youth come to harvest, your wife alike shall reap a proper man. There lies your way. Due west, then westward ho.
Grace and good disposition attend your ladyship.
Stay! Prithee, tell me what thou thinkest of me.
That you do think you are not what you are.
If I think so, then I think the same of you.
Then think you right. I am not what I am.
I would you, as I have you be.
Would that be better, madam, than I am?
I wish it might, for now I am your fool.
In an act of scorn, how beautiful. In the anger and contempt of his lip. A murderer's guilt would not show itself sooner than a love that is to be hid. A love's night is noon. Cesario.
By the roses of the spring, by maidenhood, honor, truth, and truth, everything, I love thee. So then, murder all thy pride. I when no reason can my passion hide.
Do not extort thy reasons from this cause, for then I woo. Thou hast no cause, no reason does rather than reason feather. Love sounds good, but given unto it is better. By my innocence, I swear, and by my youth, I have has, nor never none shall mistress be of it save I alone. And so, adios, good madam. Nevermore will I my master's tears to you deplore.
And yet come again, for thou perhaps mayst move thy heart which now abhors to like his love.
No, Faith, I'll not stay a jot longer.
Thy reason, dear Venom, give thy reason.
You must needs yield your reason, Sir Andrew.
I saw your niece do more favors to the Duke's serving man than ever she bestowed upon me. I saw it in the orchard.
Did she see the wild, old boy? Tell me that.
As plain as I see you now.
This was a great argument of love in her towards you.
It's like, will you make an ass of me?
I will prove a legitimate, sir, upon also judgment and reason.
And they have been grand in your jurymen since before Noah was a sailor.
She did show favor to the youth in your sight only to exasperate you, to awake your demouth valor, to fire in your heart and brimstone in your liver. You should then have accosted her with some excellent jest and new fire for men. You should have banged youth into dumbness. This was looked for at your hand and balked unless you do redeem it by some laudable attempt of either valor or policy.
And if be any way, it must be with valor. For policy I hate. I had as lief be a proud boy as a politician.
Why then fill me thy fortunes upon the basis of valor?
All right.
Valor? Oh. Huh. Challenging me the Duke's youth to fight with him and to hurt him in 11 places. Ha, ho, he, ho, ha, ho, ho, ha, 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 ha. And my niece will surely take note of it, if you know what I mean.
There's no way but this, Sir Andrew.
Will either of you bear me a challenge to him?
Go, sir. Write it in martial hand. Be cursed and brief. Go! Go! Away!
Where shall I find you?
We'll call thee. Go! Get out of here! Go! Beat it, kid!
This is a dear mannequin to you, Sir Toby.
Aye, he is dear to me. Some 2,000 strong or so.
We shall have a rare letter, but you'll not deliver it.
Never, and by all means call upon the youth to an answer. If Andrew were Andrew, and they were to find enough blood in his liver to clog the foot of a flea, I'll eat the rest of the anatomy.
His appetite the youth bears in his visage, no great persage of cruelty.
Look where the youngest wren of nine comes.
If you desire the spleen, will laugh yourself into stitches. Follow me. Yon Gold Malvolio is turned heathen, a very renegado. For there is no Christian, and no Christian means to be saved by believing rightly, can ever believe such impossible passages of grossness. He's in yellow stockings.
And cross-guarded?
Most villainously. Like a pedant that keeps a school in the church, I have dogged him like his murderer. He does obey every point I made in the letter I dropped to betray him. He does smile his face into more lines than is in a new map. You have not seen such a thing as tis. Oh, I know my lady will strike him, and when she do, he'll smile and take for a great favor.
Come, bring us where he is.
On a walk.
I would not by my will have troubled you, but since you make your pleasure of your pains, I will no further chide you.
I could not stay behind you. My desire more sharp than filed steel did spur me. And not all who love to see you, though so much as might have drawn one to a longer voyage, but jealousy, what might befall your travel, be skillless in these parts, which to a stranger unguided and unfriended often prove rough and unhospitable. My willing love, rather by these arguments of fear set forth in your pursuit.
My kind Antonio, I can no other answer make, but thanks and thanks and ever thanks. And oft good turns are shuffled off with such uncommon pay.
But were my worth as is my conscience firm, you should find better dealing.
Better dealing?
What's to do? Shall we go see the relics of this?
Oh, tomorrow's service?
First, go see your lodging.
I'm not weary and tis long tonight. I pray you, let us satisfy our eyes with the memorials and things of fame that do renown this city.
Oh, dear Sebastian, would you pardon me? I do not without danger walk these streets.
Once in a sea fight, with the Duke and his galleys, I did some service of such note indeed that where I say and hear it was scarce the answer.
Belike you slew great number of his people.
Sebastian, the offense is not such of a bloody nature, albeit the quality of the time and quarrel. It might well have given us such a bloody argument. I mean, it might have since been answered in repaying what we took from them, which, for traffic's sake, most diversity did, only myself stood out, for which, if I be last in this place, I shall pay dear.
Do not then walk too open.
Oh, it does not fit me. Oh, I just remembered I have something for you. Where did I put it? In this pocket? No, was it? Which pocket did I put this in? Here we go. Hold, sir. Here is my purse. In the south suburbs of the... Claremont. The south suburbs of the Claremont is the lodge. I will bespeak our diet, whilst you beguile the times and feed your knowledge. With the viewing of the town, there shall you have me.
Why are your purse?
Oh, Sebastian, probably your eye shall light upon some toy you have desire to purchase in your store, I think, and not for the idle market, sir.
I'll be your purse bearer and leave you for an hour.
To the Claremont?
I do remember.
I have sent after him. He says he'll come. How shall I feast? What bestow of him? For youth are oft more bought than begged or borrowed. I speak too loud. Where is Malvolio? He is sad and civil and suitable for a servant of my fortunes. Where is Malvolio?
Oh, he's coming, madam.
But in a very strange manner. He is sure
possessed.
Madam. Why? What's the matter? Does he rave?
No, he does nothing but smile. Your ladyship were best to have some guard about you. Oh, if he come, that man is sure tainted in wits.
Go call him hither. For I am as mad as he, if sad and merry madness equal thee.
Go.
What? Ho, Malvolio.
Hold on. I don't hear you.
Smilest thou, I have sent for thee upon a sad occasion.
A sad lady?
I could be sad.
This does make for some obstruction in the blood, this
cross-garter.
But what of that? If it please the eye of one, it is with me as the very true sonnet is. Please one, please all.
Why abdost thou, man? What is the matter with thee?
Not black in my mind, though. Yellow in my leg. It did come to his hands, and command shall be executed. I think we all know the sweet Roman hand.
Wilt thou go to bed, Malvolio?
To bed? Aye, sweetheart, and I'll come to thee.
God comfort thee. Why doth thou kiss thy hand and smile so?
How do you, Malvolio?
At your request, yes, nightingale's answer does.
Why do you appear with such ridiculous boldness before my lady?
Be not afraid of greatness.
What meanest thou by that, Malvolio?
Some are born great,
Huh?
Some achieve greatness.
What sayest thou?
And some have greatness.
Thrust upon me!
Remember who commended thy yellow stockings.
Thy yellow stockings?
And wish to see thee ever cross-guarded.
Cross-guarded?
Go to, thou art made if thou desirest to be so.
Am I made?
Or if not, let me see thee a servant still.
Why, this is very midsummer madness.
Madam, the young gentleman of the Duke Orsino has returned. I can hardly entreat him back. He attends your ladyship with pleasure.
I'll go to him. Good Mariah, let this fellow be looked to. Where's my cousin Toby? Let some of my good people take special care of him. I would not have him miscarry for the half my dowry. Stay right there, don't talk to me.
And get up.
Did you see that? Do you come near me now? No worse man than Sir Toby to look to me. This concurs directly with the letter. She sends him on purpose that I may appear stubborn to him, for she incites me to that in the letter. Cast thy humble slough, says she, be opposite with a kinsman, surly with servants, let thy tongue tang with arguments of state, put thyself into the trick of singularity, and consequently sets down the manner how. As a sad face, a reverend carriage, a slow tongue, and in the habit of some servant, and so forth. I have limed her. But it is Jove's doing, and Jove make me thankful. And when she went away just now, let this fellow be looked to. Not Malvolio, nor after my degree, but fellow. Why, everything adheres together. That no scruple, no dram of a scruple, no scruple of a scruple, no incredulous or unsafe circumstance. What can be said? Nothing that can be could come between me and the full prospect of my hopes. Well, Jove, not I, is the doer of this, and he is to be thanked.
Which way is he in the name of sanctity? If all the devils of hell be drawn in little, and each himself possessed. Yet I'll speak to him.
Here he is.
Have it with you, sir. Have it with you, ma'am.
Go off. I discard you. Let me enjoy my private. Go off.
Flo, how hollow the fiend speaks within him.
Oh, did I not tell you? Sir Toby, my lady prays you have a care of him.
Does she so?
Go to. Peace. We must deal gently with him. Let me elope with him. How now, my boy? How's it with you? How you do?
What a man! Defy the devil! Consider he's an enemy to mankind?
So what you say?
And how the devil speaks within him! How he takes that heart! Pray God he be not bewitched!
Carry his waters to the wise woman.
Marry, and it shall be done tomorrow morning. If I live, my lady will not lose him for more than I'll say.
How now, mistress?
Prithee, hold thy peace. This is not the way. Do you not say you move him? Let me alone with him.
Sir.
Aye, maybe come with me, what man? Tis not for gravity to play a cherry pit with Satan. Hang him, foul collier.
Well, what are you doing? Give him to pray, good priest. Give him to pray.
My prayers, mate.
Oh, no, I warrant you. He will not your godliness.
Go hang yourselves all. You are idle, shallow things. I am not of your element. I'm more hereafter.
Get him.
If this were played upon a stage now, I could condemn it as improbable fiction.
Oh, his very genius had taken the infection of the device.
Nay, pursue him, lest his device take air and tank.
And why, we shall make him mad indeed.
Come, I'm in a dark room and bound. My niece is already in the belief that he's mad. We will carry it thus, for our pleasure and his, penance. It's not very pastime. But see!
More of a matter for a man, Warren.
Shh!
Here's the challenge. Read it. Warren, there's vinegar and pepper in it.
Is it so saucy?
Aye, it is. I warned him. Do but read. Oh, thanks. Want some? give me that. Give me that.
Youth, whatsoever thou art but a scabby fellow.
Good and valiant.
Wonder not, nor admire not the man, and why I do call thee so, for I will show thee no reason for it.
A good note that keeps you from the blow of the law.
Thou killest the Lady Olivia, and in my sight she uses thee kindly. But thou liest in the throat, that is not the matter I challenge thee for. No.
Very brief and good to exceeding senseless.
I will willingly be going home, where if it be thy deed that is to kill me.
Good.
You will kill me like a rogue and a villain.
But still you keep on the windy side of the law. Good.
Fare thee well. God have mercy upon one of our souls. He may have mercy upon mine, but my hope is better. So look to thyself, thy friend, and thy usest him, and thy sworn enemy, Andrew Aguchi. You done? There's other moves not his legs cannot. I'll gift him.
He has very fit occasion for it. He is in some comrades with my lady and will be by depart.
Go, sir, scout me for him at the corner of the orchard, like a, what do they call it? Like a boom belly. Away!
They let me alone for swearing.
Now, you will find that it comes from a cloth pole. But sir, I will deliver his challenge by word of mouth. Send upon Andrew this notable report of the porter. This will drive the gentleman into the most hideous opinion of his rage, skill, and fury. And this will drive them both. So that they will kill one another by the look, like Medusa's. And please give me that one once more.
Here he comes with your niece. Give them word till they take leave presently after him.
How many did the wall of want a message for a challenge?
I have said too much unto a heart of stone and laid mine honor too on sherry ounce. There is a part of me that does reprove my fault, but such a headstrong and potent fault it is that it but mocks reproof. With the same behavior that your passion bears goes on my master's grief. Here, take this key, for 'tis the key to my heart. Refuse it not, for it hath no tongue to vex you. I beseech you come again tomorrow, for what may you ask of me that I may deny that ask upon asking may give?
Nothing but this, your true love for my master. With mine honor, how may I give to him with what I have given to you?
I will acquit you.
I beseech you come again tomorrow. Fare thee well. A fiend like thee might bear my soul to hell.
Gentlemen, God save thee.
And you, sir.
At that fence thou hast, I know not, but thy interceptor, bloody as the hunter, attends thee at the orchard end, where thy assailant is quick, skillful. And deadly.
You mistake, sir. I am sure no man hath any quarrel with me. My remembrance is very free and clear from any image of offense done to any man.
Oh, you'll find otherwise, I assure you. Therefore, if you take your life at any price, betake you to your God. For the opposite hath in him your youth, your skill, your fury, and your wrath.
Pray, sir, what is he?
He is knight. He's a devil. Souls and bodies? Hath he divorced? How many of them? Three. A satisfaction that can be numbed by the pangs of death. Hope not, is his word. Give her tate.
I will return again into the house and desire some conduct of the lady. I am no fighter. I have heard of some kinds of men who put quarrels purposely on others to taste their valor. Belike this is a man of that quirk.
Sir, no, get you one, and give him his desire. Back you shot to the house, therefore on, or strip your sword stark naked. For metal you must, that is certain, or forswear to wear iron about you.
This is as uncivil as strange. I beseech you, do me the courteous office to know of this knight what my offense is to him. It is something of my negligence, nothing of my purpose.
I'll do so. Fabian, stay you by this gentleman until my return.
Pray, sir, know you of this matter?
I know the knight has insisted against you.
I beseech you, what manner of man is he?
He is indeed the most bloody fatal opposite you could have possibly found in any part of Oakland. I make your peace with him if I can.
I would be much bound to you for it. I'm the kind that had rather go with Sir Priest than Sir Knight. I care not who knows so much of my mettle.
You got this. They say he's a very devil. They say it in words. Duke.
Tell him, Ethel Whistler.
Hey, you get back here, Miss Hartman. Get back. Hey, Fabian can scare toward him yonder.
Flagon in, and I thought he had been valiant and so cunning. I'll just lead him down there. I'll have challenged him.
What the matter slipping me? Chief of my test.
Stand here, make a good show on. And I'll make the motions. And this shall end without the perdition of souls, okay? Gonna be okay? Okay, here we go. Oh, right as Tesla was I about you. Fabian! I have his Tesla to take up the quarrel. And I have persuaded him that the youth's a devil.
He pants and looks as pale as if a bear were in the field.
He does. Okay. Sir, there's no remedy. The gentleman will fight with you, but he protests he won't harm you.
May God defend me! A little thing would make me tell them how much I lack of a man.
Give him ground if you see him furious.
There's no remedy, Sir Andrew. The gentleman will have one bout with you, but he promises me, as a gentleman soldier, he won't harm you. Come on, toot!
Plague on it, he keep his oath.
I assure you, 'tis against my will.
Will you do? Now my necessity makes me
part prompted by your present trouble. Out of my lean and low ability, I'll lend you something. Having is not much. I'll make division of my present with you. Here, there's half my coffer.
Do you deny me now? Do not tempt my misery. Least that he thinks me so without a man to upbraid you with those kindnesses that I've done for you.
What, sir? I know of none, nor know I you by voice or any feature. I hate ingratitude more in a man than lying, babbling, vainness, drunkenness, or any other taint of vice whose strong corruption inhabits our frail blood.
Oh, heaven, that's now!
Come, sir, I pray you go.
Let me speak a little. This youth that you see here, I squat a hand out of the jaws of death and reveal him with such sanctity of love to his image, which may thought most horrible work than I devotion.
What's that to I? The time goes by, away.
But oh, how vile and idle proves this god thou hast Sebastian done good features. In nature, there is no blemish but the mind, none calls thee form but the unkind. Virtue is beauty, but the beauty is evil, or epitrophs are flourished by the devil.
Man grows mad, away, sir.
Leave me on.
Hey, I'm not afraid to arrest you too as well. Oh God, I sound like a cop. Oh.
His words do from such passion fly that he believes himself. So not do I. Oh, prove true, imagination, prove true that I, dear brother, not be taken for you. He named Sebastian. I, my brother, know, yet living in my glass, even such and so in favor was my brother. And so when he's still in this color, fashion, ornament, him I imitate. Oh, if it prove, tempests are kind, and salt waves fresh in love.
The very dishonest poultry boy, more coward than a hare. His dishonesty appears in leaving his friend here in necessity. As for his cowardship, ask Fabian.
A coward, a most devout coward, religious, isn't it?
Nay, I'll after him again, and beat him!
Yes, do. Cuff him soundly, but never draw thy sword.
And I do not.
Come on, let's see the event.
Nay, I don't lay any money, told me nothing yet.
I am not sent for you. Go to, thou art a foolish fellow. Let me be clear of thee.
Well, held out thy faith. No, I am not sent to you by my lady. Nor your name is not Master Cesario. Nor this is not my name, neither. Nothing that is so is so.
I pretty fool. Bid thy folly somewhere else. Thou knowest not me.
Vent my folly. I prithee now ungrid thy strangeness and tell me what I shall vent to my lady. Shall I vent the order coming?
I bid thee, here's money for thee. If thy tarry any longer, I shall give worse payment.
Well, those men who give good fools money give themselves a good report. Very well.
Now, sir, have I met thee again? There's for you.
Why, there's for thee, and there, and there? Are all the people mad?
Hold, sir, I'll throw your dagger out of the house.
This story is on my lady's face.
Come on, sir, hold.
Nay, sir, let him alone. Go another way to work with him. I'm catching a battery against him. If there be any law in open. Though I struck him first, yet it's no matter for that.
Let go my hand.
Come on, sir. You are well fleshed. Come on, put up your iron.
What wouldst thou now? If thou darest tempt me further, draw thy sword.
All right. I shall have an ounce or two of this blood from you.
Hold, sir, thy life by sharp feet. Hold.
Madame.
Will it ever be thus? Ungracious wretch, fit for the barbarous carriage, and thou whose manners were nearly taught, nor priest, out of my sight. Be not a dear Cesario. Ruth, be gone! ruffian hath brushed up, and thou mayst maybe may smile at this. Thou shalt not choose but go, do not deny. Beshrew his soul for me. He's one poor heart of mine in me.
What relish is in this? What runs the stream? Or I am mad, or else this is a dream. Let fancy fill my river and river steep if it be thus a dream. Still let me sleep.
Nay, wilt thou to be ruled by me?
Madame, I will.
Oh, say so and so be.
I just wanted you to know.
To him, priest, top ass.
What?
No, top ass.
No, we're not doing this. No,
It smells like old man in here. Oh my God. What old peace in the prison? Who calls there?
Oh, Thomas the priest, who comes to visit my barely over the lunatic?
Oh, Father Thomas, priest Thomas, good sir Thomas, go, my lady.
I'll type about the fiend, how vexest thou this man? Talkest thou nothing but of ladies?
Father Thomas, never was man thus wronged. Good sir Thomas, do not think I am mad. They have laid me here in hideous darkness.
Oh, fie, thou dishonest Satan. Sayest thou this horse's dog?
As hell, priest Thomas.
Why cast transparent bay windows and lustrous as ebony, and yet complainest thou of obstruction?
I am mad, sir Thomas. I say to you, this house is darkness.
Then thou liest. I say there is no darkness, but ignorance. In which thou art more puzzles than the San Francisco is nipple.
But this house is ignorance, though ignorance were as dark as hell. Never was man so notoriously was good sir Thomas. I am no more mad than you are. Make the trial of it in any constant question.
What is the opinion of Pythagoras?
That the soul of our grandam might happily inhabit a bird?
And what is thy opinion of his opinion?
I think nobly of the soul, and in no way approve his opinion.
Oh, fare thee well, remain still in the darkness.
Oh, Father Thomas, priest Thomas, come back.
God bless thee, master priest. Oh, farewell, I am.
To him in that old voice.
Fool? Fool, I say! Fool! As ever thou wilt deserve while at my hand, help me to a candle and ink, pen, and paper. As I am a gentleman, I will live to be thankful to thee for it.
Oh, Master Malvolio!
Aye, good fool, it's me!
Alas, sir, how beside your five wits?
Oh, good fool, never was so those abused. But, sir, oh, good fool, I am no offense but my wits, as you are!
But as well, then you are mad indeed. If no better, then your wits, you're a fool.
Oh, they have your property, they keep me in darkness, and miss to me asses. All they can do to face me out of my wits!
Oh, advise you what you say, the minister's here! Who, I, sir, not I, sir. Marry a man, marry a father, tough as I will, sir, I will!
Father Thomas!
Alas, sir, be patient. What you say, sir?
Oh, Mr. Thomas, please, a candle and pen and paper. I am as well in my wits as any man in Oakland.
Oh, alas, sir, what you say?
Thank you, good fool. Oh, I'm acquainted in the highest degree. 'tis the glorious sun. I do feel it and see it. And though 'tis wonder that warps me thus, yet 'tis not madness. Where's Antonio then? I could not find him at the Claremont. Yet there he was. There I found this credit that he did range the town to seek me out. His counsel now might do me golden soldiness. For though my soul disputes well with my sense that this may be some error, but no madness. Yet doth this accident, a flood and fortune exceed all instance and all disgrace that I am ready to distrust mine eyes and wrangle to any other reason but truth, but that I am mad? Or else the lady's mad. Yet if 'twere so, she could not sway her house, command her followers, take and give back commands in their dispatch with such a smooth, discreet, and stable bearing as I perceive she has. There's something in it that is deceivable. Oh, but here the lady comes.
Blame not this haste of mine, for if you mean well, go with me and with this holy man to the chantry by. There, before him and under the consecrated roof, plight me the full assurance of your faith so that my most jealous and too doubtful soul may live at peace. He shall conceal it, as you are willing it shall come to note, what time we will, our celebration in accordance to my birth. What do you say?
I'll follow this good man, and go with you, and having sworn truth ever will be true.
Then lead the way, good father, and heaven so shine, so that they may fairly note this act of mine.
The better for my foes, and the worse for my friends.
Why, this is excellent.
By my truth, sir, no, but it does please you to be one of your friends.
Thou shalt not be worse for me. There's gold.
But it would be good dealing, sir, you could make it another.
Oh, you give me ill counsel.
Put your grace in your pocket, sir, for this once, and let your flesh and blood obey it.
I will be so much a sinner as to be a double dealer.
Oh, first, second, third was a good play, and I'll put you in mine. Farewell.
Here comes the man, sir, that did rescue me.
That face of his I do remember well, yet when I saw it last, it was besmeared as black as Vulcan in the smoke of war. A captain of a bobbling vessel was he, and with such bulk unprizable, with such scathful grapple did he make the bottom half of our fleet leap. So much so, the very tongue of fame and honor cried, fame and honor on him. What's the matter?
Orsino, this is that Antonio that took the phoenix and her frock from Candy. And this is he that did the tiger board when your young nephew Titus lost his leg. Poor kid. Out here in the streets, desperate of shame and state, in private gravel did I apprehend him.
He did me kindness, sir, drew on my side, but in conclusion put strange speech upon me. I know what was but was raction.
Oh, thou notable pirate, Thou salt water, thief, foolish boldness has brought thee to their mercies, whom thou, in terms so bloody and so dear, hast made thine enemies.
Mercy, no, no. That I shake off these names you give me. Antonio never yet was thief or pirate, though I confess on base and ground enough was his enemy, a witchcraft, drew me hither, the most ungrateful boy there by your side. From the roots, teased and raged in foamy mouth, did I redeem a right past. His life I gave him, and there to add my love without retention or restraint. On his dedication, for his sake, did I expose myself, fear for his love, into the dangers of this adverse town. Drew to defend him when he was beset, or being apprehended his false cunning, not meaning to partake with me in danger, taught him to face me out of his acquaintance. No one would wink, deny me my own purse. I had recommended to his use half an hour before.
How can this be?
When camest thou to this town?
Today, my lord. Today, Sebastian. And I remember for 3 months straight before then. And no intern on him in his vacancy. Both day and night did we keep company.
Here comes the countess. Now the goddess walks on earth. But for thee, fellow, thy words are madness. For 3 months hath he tended on my side, but more of that anon. Take him away.
What would my lord but that he may not have wherein Olivia may seem serviceable? Cesario? You do not keep promise with me, madam.
Most gracious Olivia.
What say you, Cesario? Good, my lord.
My lord would speak. My duty hushes me.
If it is as fat and fulsome to mine ears as howling after music, then I have heard it.
Still so cruel.
Still so constant, lord.
What to perverseness, you uncivil lady. My soul, the faithfulest offerings, that e'er devotion tender hath breathed out, what should I do?
Even what it please, my lord, that may become of him.
Would that I could, had I the heart to do it. Like to the thief at point of death, kill what I love. But hear you this, since thou to non-regardance cast my faith, and since I partly know the instrument, live you the marble-breasted tyrant still. But this your minion, whom I know you love, and whom by heaven I swear I do tender dearly, him will I pluck out of that cruel eye where he sits crowned in his master's spite. Come, boy, away. My thoughts are ripe with mischief. I'll sacrifice the lamb that I do love to spite a raven's heart within a dove.
And I, most jocund apt and willingly to do you rest, 1,000 deaths would die. Where goes Cesario? After him I love. More than I love these eyes, more than more life, more by all mores than I e'er shall love wife. If I do feign you witnesses above, punish my life for tainting of my love. Aye, me be tested, how am I beguiled? Who does beguile you? Who does you wrong? Is it so long? Hast thou forgot thyself? Call forth the Holy Father.
Cesario, come away.
Whither, my lord? Cesario, husband. Stay!
Husband!
Aye! Husband! Can he that deny?
Her husband, sir!
No, my lord, not I! Oh, do not swear. Hold little faith, for thou hast too much fear. Alas, it is the basis of thy fear that makes thee strangle thy propriety. Hold thy fortunes high. Be that thou know'st thou art, so that thou art as great as that thou fear'st. Oh, welcome, father! Father, I charge thee, here by thy reverence, here to unfold what thou doth new know hath newly passed between this youth and me.
A contract of eternal bond. Confirmed by the mutual joinder of your hands.
attested by the holy rows of lips, strengthened by the interchangement of your rings. And all the ceremony of this compact sealed in my function by my testimony. Since when, my watch had told me, toward my grave, I have traveled, but... Oh, yes. 2 hours. I must say, quite a fast man.
Oh, dissembling cub, what wilt thou be when time hath sowed a gristle on thy cheek? But let thy step be thy overthrow, and henceforth direct thy feet where thine and mine should never meet.
My lord, I do protest.
Oh, do not swear. Hold little faith that thou hast too much fear.
For the love of God, a surgeon, send one presently to Sir Toby.
What has happened?
He has broke my head across and has given Sir Toby a bloody coxcomb to love of God, your help, I would rather home.
Who is Sir Andrew?
The Duke's gentleman, one Cesario. We took him for a gower, but he is the very devil incarnate.
My boy Cesario.
Shut! Oh, lightly, there he is. He broke my head for nothing, I was sent out to do it by Sir Toby.
Why speak to me? I never hurt you. You drew your sword upon me without cause, but I bespoke you fair and hurt you not.
If a bloody coxcomb be a hurt, you have hurt me. I think you said nothing by a bloody coxcomb. Here comes Sir Toby. You shall hear more. If you had not been in, he would have tickled your other gates than he did.
How dost thou, gentlemen?
All one has hurt me. And, oh, look, there's the end on. Is he a dick surgeon, sir?
Oh, he's drunk an hour gone when his eyes first did set at 8 in the morning.
No, he's a rogue. I hate a drunken rogue.
Who has caused this havoc with Adam?
Booch!
Come, Sir Toby. I'll help you. We'll be dressed together.
Will you help? An ass head, a coxcomb, a thin-faced knave, a knave. Yeah, I hate myself.
Take him away.
Oh, mommy. It's
hard to be looked to.
I'm sorry, madame, I've hurt your kinsman. Had it been a brother, my blood must have been at no less with wit and safety. You throw a strange regard upon me, and I had perceived it offended you. Pardon me, sweet one, even for the vows we made, but so long ago.
One shape, one voice, one habit in two persons, an unnatural occurrence that isn't is not.
Antonio? Oh, my dear Antonio! How have the hours racked and tortured me since I have lost thee? Fearst thou that Antonio?
Blended two is not more equal than these creatures, which is Sebastian.
Serious? Most wonderful.
Do I stand there? I never had a brother. Nor can there be that deity of my nature appearing everywhere. I had a sister, whom the blind waves and surges have devoured. Of charity, what kin are you to me? What name, what parentage, what countryman?
Of Mexico. Sebastian was my father. Such a Sebastian was my brother, too. So when he suited to his watery tomb, spirits can assume both form and suit, you come to fright us.
And in that dimension grows the cloud from whom the wound I did participate. Were you a woman? As the rest goes even? I should, my tears left fall upon my tongue. You could say, thrice welcome drawn by Olaf.
My father had a mole upon his brow.
And so had Oh, that day that lives lively in my soul. He indeed finished his mortal act. That year my sister turned 13 years.
If nothing lets to make us happy both, then this, my masculine usurped attire, do not ignite me till each circumstance of place, time, form, and do coherent justice. I am Viola.
So comes it, lady. You have been mistook. To her nature and bias, true in that. You would have been contracted to a maid.
Nor are you, thereby my life deceived, but betrothed both to a maid and a man.
Be not surprised. Right noble know this blood. And if the glass holds true, I myself have share of this most happy wreck. Boy, thou hast said to me 1,000 times thou never should love woman like to me.
And all those sayings I will overswear, and all those swearings keep as true in heart as doth that orbed continent of fire that severs day from night.
Give me thy hand, and let me see thee in thy woman's weeds.
The captain that brought me first on shore hath my maid's garments. He, upon some action, is now in durance at Malvolio's suit, a gentleman and follower of my lady's. He shall be delivered. Where is Malvolio? And yet, I remember me, they say, poor gentleman, he is much distract. In a most extracting frenzy of mine own hath clearly banished him from my remembrance. How does he, sirrah?
Oh, truly, madam, he holds Belzebub, Satan, and the devil at the stave's end, as in his case may do. He has wrote a letter to you.
Oh, open, then read it.
Look, then, to be edified when the fool delivers
what,
the
man. Art thou mad?
What, madam? You must allow what? Oh, my gosh.
Prithee, read by thy right wits.
My lord, madam, you wrong me, and the world shall know it. Though you have put me into darkness and given your drunken cousin rule over me, yet I have the benefit of my senses as well as your ladyship. I have your own letter that induced me to the semblance I put on, with which I doubt not to do myself much right or you much shame. Think of me as you please. I leave my duty a little unthought of and speak out my injury. The madly used Malvolio.
Did he write this?
Aye, madam.
This savor is no distraction.
See him delivered. Fabian, go call him hither. My lord, so please you. These things once further thought on to see me as well a sister as a wife. This alliance shall be crowned one day, so here, at my house and at my proper cost.
Madam, I am most apt to embrace your offer. Your master quits you, and for the service done so far beneath the mettle of your sex, so much beneath your soft and tender breeding. But since you called me master for so long, here is my hand, so shalt thou be thy master's mistress.
A sister, you are she.
Where is she? You! Lady, you have done me wrong. Notorious wrong.
Have I? No!
Lady, you have. Pray you, peruse this letter. You must not now deny it is your hand. Write from it if you can in hand or phrase, or say 'tis not your seal, your invention. You can say none of this. Well, grant it then, and tell me in the modesty of honor why you have given clear lights of favor, made me come smiling and cross-garter to you, to frown upon Sir Toby and the lighter people, and acting this in obedient hope, to why have you suffered me to be imprisoned, kept in a dark house, visited by the priest, and made the most notorious gag and golden air invention to play out? Tell me why!
Alas, Malvolio, this is not my writing! Though I much like the character, 'tis out of question, 'tis Mariah's hand. And now I do bethink me, 'twas she who first told me thou wast mad, then camest in smiling and in such forms that were presupposed upon thee in the letter. Prithee, be content. This act hath most shrewdly passed upon thee, but once we know both the grounds and authors of it, thou shalt be both plaintiff and judge of thine own cause.
Good madam, hear me speak.
Let no quarrel nor no brawl come to taint the condition of this present hour, which I have wondered at. In hope it shall not most freely, I confess myself and Toby, set this device here against Malvolio, upon some stubborn current of his parts we have conceived against him. For I writ the letter I showed Toby's great importance, for a recompense he hath married her. How with the sportful malice that followed, may rather pluck on laughter than revenge. If that dreams both sides pass, be justly weighed.
Poor fool! How baffled thee?
Why, some are born great, some achieve greatness, and some have greatness thrusted upon them. Oh, he's so slow in his revenges.
Treat him to a peace. A solemn combination shall be made of all our souls. So shalt thou be when thou art a man. When in other habits you are seen, Orsino's mistress and his fancy's queen.
Begun with hey ho, the wind and the